Whatever your life's journey, I challenge you to wake up and dream. Introducing to you a day in the life of Cherrie McRae, which I like to call the reveal. So pay attention, listen up, because this is going to be an exciting ride. Hey guys, this is Cherrie, and I'm so glad you all joined me today. It is a day in the life of Cherrie McRae, and I just wanted to kind of walk you all through what I do on scene, as well as off camera. And we're on the scene of The Hunt, which is an awesome thriller. And I am Amy, so I am a vampire vixen on this set. But just go ahead and follow me. Come on, we're gonna go ahead and go in and give you guys just a little snippets of what I do during my workday. All right, come on.
Before I was born, he said, if you want your son to have a clean
this that door was covered the last time too, though. It was, but you're good. I'm good. Me, I'm just. Here goes the items which you hate so much. Your accommodations are spot. Yes, indeed. She doesn't like a lot of stuff. Easier to clean up the mess, eh?
Minimal.
All right, Zia, please, son. Come here, babe.
Okay.
All right. Do you have everything?
Do you have everything?
And that was definitely
that,
dope.
Yeah, I know. It's like, remind the night before.
Jeez. Yeah, they're pretty. They're something else.
Yeah, that came out of her boy's mouth. Mm-hmm.
Mic fell off.
Larry! You scared the mess out of me. You scared me, Larry.
Yeah, I thought about that too, but I don't want to get stuck being an instructor, because I know people that have done that. Been like,
does not want to stop using AOL. She's like, I don't want to use Gmail. I don't want to schedule.
It's all right with children.
Start.
Yeah, we're excited.
Well, that and also if they got injuries.
Oh, okay.
But I am on the set of Things My Daddy Should Have Told Me, and it is a phenomenal, phenomenal project. I have some great acting partners and crew members, and we're just having a great time today. This is actually our last scene, which is actually a reception scene for two of the characters. And my character happens to be Mira, and Mira is sassy, saucy. She has a little pizzazz to her, you know. So I'm definitely enjoying playing her just day to day. And so today we are actually wrapping up the film project. And I must say it's very exciting. Just laughing, joking, you know, of course working. But again, this is just a little snippet of what I got going on today. And you guys stay tuned. Again, Things My Daddy Should Have Told Me. And we are definitely looking forward to you all being able to take a peek at it. All right, so I will talk to y'all later. Hi, guys. Of course, this is Cherrie. This is the last little leg of my A Day in a Life. And as you all know, I am an actress here locally in Atlanta. And I have with me Miss Lindsay Blackwell.
Hi.
Say hi, Lindsay.
Hi, guys.
So, of course, this isn't your typical Wendy Williams or talk show. I don't know why my videographer gave me this mic, but I will use it. Yes. So, anyway. Just wanted to share with you all her experiences. We were actually on set of, what, Killing for Time?
Yes.
which is an awesome independent project. You all will see that when it comes out. But we actually really enjoyed being a set mother and set daughter. And she did an awesome job. And I'll let her tell a little bit about, you know, her work and her experiences as a child actor, because she's superb. But of course, I just wanted to get someone else's viewpoint or opinion about working with myself. And of course, this is both a passion for both Lindsay and I. Yes. And so as my set daughter, Lindsay, what was the feeling? Like, how did you feel, like our chemistry and things like that? Like, tell us a little bit about your experiences. Even if you want to tell the sleeping on the couch story, it's okay.
Okay, so my experience as an actor with Miss Cherrie was,
be careful,
awesome. And I just feel like she was like one of my favorite stage moms, I guess. Well, not so much of the stage mom, but set mom. And okay, so I had a lot of fun with her, and I felt like she was like my actual mom. Like, she was like taking care of me, and I remember I almost fell down the steps, and she was like, she was helping me, and it was hilarious. But okay, so there was this time when she I was coming to set, and I found that she was laying on the couch, sleep, in a coat, and she was like, she looked so tired and so sleepy. And then today, she told me that she got there earlier than the crew, and I was like, oh wow,
yeah,
I've never done that before.
Mike Allen.
I've never done that before.
Yes.
So I was kind of surprised when she was there sleeping on the couch, and I was like, when did you get here? Like, when did you get here? And it was really funny. Yeah.
So, of course, as Lindsay said, I was actually her stepmom. And we really enjoyed it. Of course, for many of you that are actors, you do understand that you spend a large amount of time on set. And so a lot of times when you're on set with other people, you become what I like to call family. And not family, but family. And that's exactly how close-knit we became. I definitely want to try to maneuver or see how we can work things out to where we can work together again. Because
yeah.
Like I said, I love working with other passionate talent. And that is definitely Lindsay. And she's doing big things. Shout out to
yes.
Lindsay. You have something coming up now, don't you?
Yes. I'm going to be in a play called Madeline's Christmas. And it's a play about 12 little girls. And Madeline, we all get sick. And she kind of helps us along with a man named Harsha. And they help us get well. And it's supposed to be a Christmas story. And I'm enjoying practicing right now. It's like amazing.
Isn't she the best? She is just everything. So anyway, that's just a little snippet that I wanted to share with you all. I just didn't want it to be so much just me talking about me and giving you all just an inside scoop of my day-to-day, or as close to as my day-to-day as I can give you. But I also wanted to just share this moment with Lindsay. Because you definitely will see a lot more of her. She's definitely doing some big things. So we enjoy you guys. Thank you for tuning in to just this part of it. And a day in the life of Cherrie. Thank y'all. Let's see. What made me want to become an actor? Not too long ago, during my college days, I actually took a theater appreciation course. I did not want to. I was a business major, and I was just like, I just need to take something where I'm going to get a good grade because I need to get out of here. So basically, that's my introduction to theater, film, television, all that good stuff. And I got into corporate America for a short while, and I realized it just wasn't for me. And so my first opportunity was, actually, I got into radio first. And I love radio. I love being a radio personality. And then eventually I got into television hosting. And I enjoyed that as well. And then, of course, when you're good at something and you have the personality for it, Most often you'll get other opportunities and word will spread that, oh yeah, she's great with a script, she's great with this, she has a great look or a great feel and a lot of charisma on camera. And so that feeling in itself, aside from, you know, Cubicle Nation, which is corporate America, was completely different from the feeling of acting and being on stage and being in front of the camera. And just it provided a different energy. And I realized at that moment that I really had a craving for the arts. And so again, I stuck with it and I am still here today, 5 years later. And I'm definitely enjoying everything about it and getting into some directing and some writing as well. And so I feel the sky is not the limit. So that is why I wanted to become an actress. Well, I believe that my contribution, you know, as it relates to the arts and giving back and things of that nature is one thing that's different about me and different about my style is that I take on a more organic approach. And so a lot of the characters that I portray or a lot of the scripts that I study, I make sure that there is some way that I can tap into what aspect of that is Cherrie. Although I may be playing all of these different characters, what aspect of it is me? And how can I make the most truthful choice in whatever it is that I do? So I feel that my contribution is really honestly relating to an audience without seeing my audience and just making absolutely sure that I don't do the script or the writer or my fans or viewer a disservice. And so that's what I feel my contribution as an actress is. Where do I see myself in 5 years? Wow. Well, I like to think that, you know, I'm going to continue striving for those bigger projects. But of course, I definitely see myself receiving continual accolades. Of course, getting bigger and better projects because I believe in my heart of hearts that the bigger my platform, the bigger my impact. And so I feel that that's, you know, what I was created and designed to do. And the only way to really affect or get the exposure that's needed to reach a vast majority of people is to build and build and build. And so the projects that I do, the people that I work with, producers and directors that I meet, I always try to make sure that I leave a lasting impression. Because of course that's a part of the game as well. But I also just want to make sure that each person that I come into contact with, I feel that I am my own individual ministry. And so how I treat people, how I make them feel, whether it's in front of the camera or behind the camera, I feel that that is my ultimate fulfillment, purpose, passion, and my destiny. And so in 5 years, I just would hope to continue to build upon, you know, legacy, building blocks for myself, for my children, for my children's children, and just making sure that I am moving in the direction of being a role model and a leader for my community of actors and artists and talent. So that is the finale of A Day in the Life of Cherrie McRae. And thank you all for joining us. We appreciate you. We appreciate your support, and we love you. And so, Lindsay, what are we about to do?
Ice cream. We get turned up.
Turned up. Squaggles. Bye.
Hey.
So I am here at the TPN Film Festival, and I was nominated for Wounded Hearts, written and directed by Bridget Black, as Best Actress nominee. Now, this is after the film festival, and I won! I won. So I'm super excited. Just the last little bits and pieces of A Day in the Life. Just really want to just expound on the fact that, you know, when you work hard and push hard and you don't really look for applause, you really just do it because of the passion and the art, you know, and the direction that God has really taken me to as far as my purpose. I'm super excited. I know it's only but the grace. And this is just simply, you know, a day in my life.
I do a lot of behind the scenes stuff that not very many people know about, but I am definitely blessed, and I feel every bit of that this evening. And I just thank again the TPN Film Festival committee, Bobby Peoples, Renee Peoples, also thanking Bridget Ladd, which is the director, as well as the writer of Wounded Hearts, to even think and consider me as one of her cast. And again, I just believe that there is more to come. So be on the lookout for me, Cherrie McRae. And I believe I am Oscar worthy. There's a little bit more to go, and I am still believing in God for that. But at the end of the day, I am focused, and I am ready, and I am hireable. Yes, I said it. So if you want to keep up with my journey, I thank you all for following the journey. This is actually the end of the road for this particular documentary. But you can keep up with my journey. On Facebook, I'm Cherrie McRae. And on Instagram, I am Lady_Cray, C-R-A-N. And Twitter, I am Cher, C-H-E-R, Ray, R-A-E. So I thank you all for following me. And again, this is a great ending to a very long journey. So again, keep on the lookout.
She's just a girl and she's on fire.